DSAP is disseminated superficial actinic porokeratosis. It is a relatively rare skin disorder related to genetics and sun exposure, and to date there is no known treatment to get rid of it. Now, I am a fair-skinned redhead and have had it on my arms and legs for at least 30 to 40 years. As you can imagine, I have tried many possible treatments. Generally, over time, DSAP gets worse. Spots get bigger, redder, and have rougher edges. I think you can see that in this more or less lined up pair of photos of my left arm in 2011 and 7 years later in 2018. My dermatologist's latest recommendation was for field treatment using a combination of fluorouracil and calcipotriene creams. This method was reported to be fairly successful for removing actinic keratoses. To my knowledge, no studies have been done with it on DSAP, so I thought I would share some of my experience and photos of this treatment over time. Maybe this can help inform other patients and perhaps those dermatologists who haven't seen a lot of DSAP. I did two trials using the fluorouracil and calcipotriene. The first was for 7 days and only on my left arm. The second was about 2 years later and for 14 days on both arms. Here's what the left hand looked like. Before the first treatment, in the middle of the second, where you see the typical inflammation caused by the treatment, and 4 months after the second treatment. There were still some issues at the end, especially at the knuckle, but lesions looked better and smoother, not as deep. This is the outer side of the left arm before and after the 7 day treatment. Unfortunately, I also have a lot of freckles, so it is difficult to tell exactly what is going on from just the images. Look at the redder spots, not just the brown freckles. I felt that the improvement was very encouraging. A number of the rough red spots were much less visible. There were still some active-looking spots, though. What happened after that, over time? Here's a comparison of images approximately 1 year and 2 years after treatment. By 22 months after the 7 day treatment, some of the reddish spots seemed to be increasing. I decided to try the technique again, this time for 14 days as suggested by my dermatologist. So here is a comparison of before and after the subsequent 14-day treatment on the left arm, showing again substantial improvement, at least in my opinion, based on the look and the smoothness of the feel. Here's a repeat of some of the photos I just showed you to illustrate the overall change in the left arm via the two sequential treatments, so all the way from before the 7 day treatment till 5 months after the end of the 14 day treatment, which was 2 years later. Here's another view of the same arm. The pink color has not entirely gone away, but the arm feels almost entirely smooth. Yes! Much better, in my opinion. These images compare the inflammation during the two treatments on the left arm. They were taken at approximately the same length of time from initiating treatment. The inflammation on day 12 of the 7 day treatment was less than the inflammation on day 14 of the 14 day treatment. It took a few more days for the reddened 14-day treatment areas to develop the lifted edges and begin peeling. Most of those spots were peeling by day 20. Sure looks bad during the process, doesn't it? Did it hurt? For me, not particularly. Along with the peeling was some itchiness, though. A few spots were hot to the touch and hurt when brushed until more healing occurred. A big question is, however, did the spots disappear totally with this treatment? I don't know. I can still see a trace of pink in the areas of the spots, so probably not. Time will tell. The treatment definitely knocked the DSAP back, though, and I think at least some bits did essentially disappear. You can see that on the second treatment, 2 years after the first. There are a few small areas that did not inflame again. Although there were also a few new ones that showed up by then. Or just became more visible in the longer treatment, perhaps. It is unknown whether the spots that disappeared were DSAP or were actually actinic keratosis mixed in among the DSAP. For completeness sake, here's what happened to the right arm in the 14-day treatment. Remember, this is the more virgin arm, the one that only went through one treatment. It too looks much better now. The initially deeper red spots faded and blended in much better with the background, and it is smoother, but still has a few small rough areas around some spots, more so than on the left arm. This hints that the accumulation of the two treatments as done on the left arm is going in a beneficial direction. Although I suspect that it is unlikely that the DSAP will totally disappear, I feel that the appearance has been greatly improved. But in addition to appearance issues, squamous cell cancers are a possibility from DSAP. I have had one squamous cell cancer biopsied and removed already on my leg, and actinic keratosis, which has also been biopsied on my leg and looks similar to DSAP, may be mixed in with a DSAP. So I feel that if this treatment can at least knock back the progression of either of those things to skin cancer, it will allow me to avoid having lots and lots of biopsies. I'm in for that. The original published procedure studying the combination of fluorouracil and calcipotriene was for actinic keratosis, not DSAP. Actinic keratosis seems easier to treat. The protocol involved twice daily application of an equal mixture of the two creams for a total of 4 days. Here's specifically what I did. I used an equal mixture of the fluorouracil, Effudex, and calcipotriene, Dovenex, as they did. The calcipotriene cream or ointment worked, either one worked, but the cream mixed a little bit faster. I used a total of 6 grams, 3 grams each, per application, covering the back of both hands and both arms, upper and lower, but did not cover the clear, delicate inside area of the arms. I applied the cream twice daily, morning and evening, for either 7 or 14 days. Here are some hopefully helpful hints for anyone who wants to try this procedure. I don't recommend doing it in the summer. Besides how bad it looks while you are doing the treatment, both creams can increase sensitivity to sunlight, which is what you really don't need. I made separate videos on mixing the creams and spreading the cream if you want to see what that looks like. Then there's dealing with the messy, sticky skin after the application. I tried to keep skin uncovered at least an hour after application. The biggest challenge was keeping applied cream on my hands and arms off my pillow and therefore out of my eyes while sleeping. My solution: 1. I applied the cream a few hours before bedtime, and 2, on each hand I wore a thin disposable nitrile glove with a sock mitt over it. To make the sock mitt, I made a slit at the heel seam of an old sock to make a slot for my thumb. I sewed two patches of Velcro on the cuff of the sock and into the inside of the sleeves of long-sleeved pajamas so that the socks could be attached to the sleeves and the sleeves would not ride up. Worked well. Comfy, cozy, and secure. No worry about getting the creams on my pillow and in my eyes. The literature reference to the original research for this treatment for actinic keratosis is shown here. I also want to thank my dermatologist at UC San Francisco for telling me about this treatment and encouraging me to try it.